people have a lot of pride in the technology. The technology space itself is definitely an interesting one.
We're really focused on improving the operating results of the companies that we do business with.
There's something really special in the MicroStrategy water, and I think that's a function of our relentless pursuit of perfection.
We really are in the business of making people smarter. We make our customers smarter, we make their executives quicker.
Business intelligence, I mean, for all, to put it in simple words, is just the ability to analyze large volumes of data and turn that data into useful information so companies can make better business decisions.
The mission of the software has been business analytics, and it's changed names over the years. It was decision support, which is why we call the product DSS Agent. Then it became business intelligence, which is really where we are today. It's had different forms in terms of whether it was delivered on the desktop or the web or in the future on the mobile device. So things have evolved around it, but the core has been being able to get at data and deliver that to the end users.
Really what we're trying to do is just make sure that people do make the best decisions possible in the environment that they're in, and we feel like they can do that if they have all the facts at their disposal. And so we've been helping corporations do that and governments do that since 1990. So in the early days, we would have 100,000 equation systems tied to maybe a gigabyte of data. Now what we'll do is have 100 terabytes of data tied to maybe 100 equations. And so again, it's much more data intensive and less equation intensive. And it turns out the data problem is actually a pretty difficult and interesting problem. So we put a lot of our heavy engineering into the data problem.
Even we, you know, at the time never could have conceived of just how rich those transactional databases were going to become. You know, back in the 90s, a rich data warehouse was SKU store day data for the last couple of years. Well, eventually what it became was a tape or a database that was every keystroke of every cashier at the second in time tied to an item charged to a credit card or a transaction purchased by a customer at a specific physical cash register. Of course, that transactional history was mated with the customer databases and the vendor databases and store databases and the employee databases. And we found applications, you know, this we never ever dreamed you would find.
If you've got the right people that are focused on the right problems for long enough, and you're gonna deliver value.
I credit our engineering team primarily with really driving just a great vision for high-end business intelligence. And if they hadn't been driving that vision so hard for so long with such commitment, I don't think we'd be recognized the way we are today.
You know, when you look at the architects, the guys that really have been around for the design of version 7 and even the very early versions of the software, version 2 and version 3, these people have been thinking about BI problems for a long time. And so you can really create value over the long haul, but you need that consistent group. You can't do it, you know, with a sort of a revolving door of thinkers. You need a set of guys who live and breathe the problems for over a decade.
The people behind it, the people that the customers interact with, the people that our partners interact with, the people that the users of our product interact with, it's ultimately the main way that they get an acknowledgement or an understanding of what MicroStrategy does. So really our people are the transformational arm that takes this piece of technology and turns it into something that can be useful to the companies that we do business with.
Obviously we have phenomenal technology, we're in a great space, but we have amazingly talented people in the organization, and they're the ones that make it work.
We have been blessed in the sense that we've been in a good market, we've had great problems to solve, we've understood them because we've been around for a long time. And we've recruited the best minds that we can get, so we've got the right problem solvers. And I think that combination is really the key to the success of the software.
If you look back at the beginning, say 10 years ago, BI might have been something that was deployed to 200 or 300 people. We routinely now have conversations with customers where they're talking about deploying business intelligence out to 100,000 people, 150,000 people. So we're trying to ride the wave of really what's happening in BI, and you could almost say it's like a democratization of the information. It used to be clustered to a small number of people. The general feeling is people make better decisions when they have more information at their fingertips, and we can be an enabler of that to those companies.
So line workers, store managers, people that are really on the front end of dealing with customers, we think should have a lot of facts at their disposal. And we think that companies have a great opportunity to empower them to make more decisions if they're really given the facts to do so. And so we're seeing a lot of our systems these days being delivered to thousands of people. And some of the more exciting projects that we see on the horizon are really our government and other governments providing their citizens with lots of data and lots of information.
Vision will change in terms of the exact technology. It's sort of clear that things are, as things move from the desktop to the web, there will be a much bigger mobile component in our software in terms of usage. We've already seen quite a bit of changes in terms of how people visualize data. I think that's going to continue. So there's going to be some bit pieces that, you know, are really just technical details. But ultimately, it's all down to driving successful customer implementations, and I think we've got the right mix to do that.
I routinely meet with our customers or people that we want to do business with who see what we want to do, see how our people apply themselves, and come away feeling like this is not only a product that I want to employ, but this is a company that I want to do business with.
For every dollar of software we sell to a customer, I'm quite convinced that they squeeze $100 of inefficiency out of their business, or they generate $100 of new revenue. And so, in a sense, we're partners with them, and the reason we're in business is because the amount of value they create from our software is so much greater than the cost of the software.